hate you. Are you gonna help me?
Special delivery. Oh. Is this a bad time?
Daddy?
Never a bad time to see my little girl, right? Hi, honey. Hey. How are you?
Hi.
Oh, good. How was school today?
Good. We made ornaments. Can we hang them up on the tree?
Of course we can. Take this off. Okay, why don't you go put your pajamas on first, and then you can come back down and we'll hang those ornaments up, okay?
Okay, Daddy.
And kiss. Bye.
Thanks for a great day. I'd do anything for that little princess. For you, too. So lay it on me. You look like you've seen a ghost.
I did. I just saw Robin.
Problems?
Apologies for the delay. I ran into a bit of trouble.
Maybe I was right. Maybe you actually do have a heart and are having second thoughts about killing me.
Appeals to my sensitive side would get you nowhere.
So you admit you have a sensitive side.
No choice in the matter. You have to be eliminated before your parents find you.
What do you mean you saw Rob?
Right there. Right across the room, clear as day. And I'm sober, Mac. I haven't taken any drugs in months.
I know you haven't.
Then what is wrong with me?
Are you feeling okay?
Aside from seeing my dead wife, the only time I had hallucinations when I was on the drugs, and I haven't taken any.
You and Emma have been doing great.
Yeah, so why am I seeing Robin now?
I'll tell you why.
Do my parents know I'm alive? Are they here?
Word of advice? Don't spend time fretting over things you can't control.
I have a life waiting for me in Port Charles. I have a husband and a daughter who love me. Please, I'm begging you.
I know what you must think, Robin, but I'm not a robot. I understand the bond between mother and child.
Well, then let me get back to my daughter.
I can't.
Why not?
Based on left instructions, failure to comply could mean my own life.
No, please.
I'm sorry for all the pain I've caused you, Robin.
Please.
There won't be any more.
Please, you can't do this. Please.
I have no choice.
Please, I'm begging you.
Close your eyes and it will be like falling asleep.
Please.
Am I going crazy?
No. No, you're in mourning.
Right. Mourning. So are you. You don't have visions of Robin?
No, but her death has hit me in other ways. You know, the thing I've learned about loss is that once you think you've got a handle on it, it blindsides you all over again.
I get missing her, you know, I get wanting to talk to her and everything, but when I see her, it's like she's real.
You know, I went shopping for Christmas presents the other day. I picked something out for Felicia and Maxie, you, Anna, Emma, and as I was lugging all my bags back to the car, I stopped short. And I mean, I physically stopped walking. Because I realized I didn't get anything for Robin. I mean, I didn't even have a present on the list for her. And I pulled my phone out in a panic. I was gonna call you, and then... And only then did reality hit me. Hey. This is your first Christmas without Robin. Okay, you gotta cut yourself some slack.
I remember it clear as day last year. We had been through so much, and we had come out the other side.
But she got me an early Christmas present. She got me a video camera. And I didn't really put two and two together at the time, but she knew that her HIV was progressing to AIDS, and...
But it hadn't. It hadn't. Robin wasn't sick. She was strong.
But it was our last Christmas together anyway.
Mom! Dad, I'm in here! Come find me!
Drag.
Mom!
It's no use. Your parents are busy elsewhere. Soon this will all be over.
Robin?
Whoa, whoa, look who's ready to decorate.
Are you staying, Papa Mac?
Oh, sweetheart, I wish I could. No one loves stringing popcorn more than me. But I've got to go to the hospital to check on Maxie, okay?
Is she sick?
No. Maxie's the picture of health. Don't you worry.
Then why is she at the hospital?
Well, because, Maxie's doing something very special. She's helping someone out. Actually, two people. And it's very brave, and it's selfless. And I really hope it works.
Me too, Daddy.
Me too. Bye.
Bye.
You're alive! Step away from the door. Oh, baby, are you hurt?
Yeah.
You all right?
I need to find me. I'm okay.
Get out of this.
Now how tough do you feel, Dr. Obrecht? Let me introduce you to my father, Robert Scorpio.
I doubt that that's a vitamin shot, so leave it there, all right?
As you wish. Dad.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Your placement is impeccable. It's perfect.
Do you like it?
I love it. You did a really good job on that thing. What do you say? You want to do the rest?
Well, can we hang our stockings first?
Yeah, we can do that. We're just going to have to find them.
Mommy's too.
What do you think?
I think Mommy has one in heaven, but we should put it up anyways, in case Santa makes a mistake and brings her presents here.
I think it's a really good idea. We wouldn't want her to not have any presents, would we? Here's Mommy's right there.
Daddy! Daddy! Daddy!